Hello and welcome to Letters from a Father to His Daughter. I'm your host Giri Bala Joshi. In this podcast, we journey through the timeless letters that Jawaharlal Nehru wrote to his daughter Indira from the confines of prison. These letters offer a fascinating exploration of the prehistoric era and the early history of the world. Through Nehru's words, you'll uncover profound insights and a deep sense of global unity and harmony. For our Hindi-speaking audience, you can find the Hindi version of this podcast on my channel. Let's dive into these letters that continue to inspire and educate generations. I will begin with a small excerpt from the preface to the first edition. Nehru writes, "But I hope that such of them as read these letters may gradually begin to think of this world of ours as a large family of nations. And I hope also, though with diffidence, that they may find in the reading of them a fraction of the pleasure that I had in the writing of them." The title of today's letter is The Book of Nature. When you and I are together, you often ask me questions about many things and I try to answer them. Now that you are at Missouri and I am in Allahabad, we cannot have these talks. I am therefore going to write to you from time to time short accounts of the story of our earth and the many countries, great and small, into which it is divided. You have read a little about English history and Indian history, but England is only a little island and India, though a big country, is only a small part of the earth's surface. If we want to know something about the story of this world of ours, we must think of all the countries and all the people that have inhabited it, and not merely of one little country where we may have been born. I am afraid I can only tell you very little in these letters of mine, but that little, I hope, will interest you and make you think of the world as a whole and of the other people in it as our brothers and sisters. When you grow up, you'll read about the story of the earth and her peoples in fat books, and you'll find it more interesting than any other story or novel that you may have read. You know, of course, that our earth is very, very old, millions and millions of years old, and for a long, long time, there were no men or women living in it. Before the men came, there were only animals, and before the animals, there was a time when no kind of life existed on the earth. It is difficult to imagine this world of ours, which is so full today of all kinds of animals and men, to be without them. But scientists and those who have studied and thought a great deal about these matters tell us that there was a time when the earth was too hot for any living being to live on it. And if we read their books and study the rocks and the fossils, the remains of old animals, we can ourselves see that this must have been so. You read history in books, but in old times when men did not exist, surely no books could have been written. How then can we find out what happened then? We cannot merely sit down and imagine everything. This would be very interesting, for we could imagine anything we wanted to and would thus make up the most beautiful fairy tales. But this need not be true, as it would not be based on any facts that we had seen. But although we have no books written in those far-off days, fortunately we have some things which tell us a great deal as well, almost as a book would. We have rocks and mountains and seas and stars and rivers and deserts and fossils of all animals. These and other like things are our books for the earth's early story. And the real way to understand this story is not merely to read about it in other people's books, but to go to the great book of nature itself. You will, I hope, soon begin to learn how to read this story from the rocks and mountains. Imagine how fascinating it is. Every little stone that you see lying on the road or on the mountainside may be a little page in nature's book and may be able to tell you something if you only knew how to read it. To be able to read any language, Hindi or Urdu or English, you have to learn its alphabet. So also you must learn the alphabet of nature before you can read her story in her books of stone and rock. Even now perhaps you know a little how to read this. If you see a little round shiny pebble, does it not tell you something? How did it get round and smooth and shiny without any corners or rough edges? If you break a big rock into small bits, each bit is rough and has corners and rough edges. It is not at all like a round smooth pebble. How then did the pebble become so round and smooth and shiny? It will tell you its story if you have good eyes to see and ears to hear it. It tells you that once upon a time, it may be long ago, it was a bit of a rock. Just like the bit you may break from a big rock or stone with plenty of edges and corners. Probably, it rested on some mountainside. Then came the rain and washed it down to the little valley where it found a mountain stream, which pushed it on and on till it reached a little river. And the little river took it to the big river. And all the while, it rolled at the bottom of the river. And its edges were worn away, and its rough surface made smooth and shiny. So it became the pebble that you see. Somehow, the river left it behind, and you found it. If the river had carried it on, it would have become smaller and smaller, till at last it became a grain of sand, and joined its brothers at the seaside, to make a beautiful beach where little children can play and make castles out of the sand. If a little pebble can tell you so much, how much more could we learn from all the rocks and mountains and the many other things we see around us? With these words, Nehru concludes this letter. In the next episode, we'll explore his insights on how early history was written. If you enjoyed this journey, you'll find more captivating content related to Nehru on this channel. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I am Giribala Joshi, and I look forward to joining you again in our next episode. Until then, take care and keep exploring.